As GSS are benching Earth right now for this last game, and Chef is coming in. And of course, also Titu. So, Count is also being benched, so that's interesting decision for them. And well, they are hoping that with the good choices of Oranos, Zeus, and Loki, they can be better than double Oranos and Loki from TSMs. That's really unusual that actually TSMs didn't choose single Zeus. But looking how they are getting a very aggressive map, they might be just in luck in here. So, let's see. They were hoping that probably that they're not going to get medit. That would have been pretty slight chance, to be honest, as it's like an only map that would be problematic for them due to the Zeus and whatnot. But otherwise, we are starting with the decider on Savannah. That's a pretty friendly map for any kind of Radiant and whatnot. So let's see how the players actually make use of that. So Fen is yet again the first we have a look at right now with the Rhinoceros in the forefront. You will need to be careful with the... Oh, you're curiously happy about the damage you're receiving. So that's one villager at half health in here. But okay, still it's a citizen. He's still left with 67 hit points, but 100 more left, which means that he will be all that much easier for actually raiding in the early age. But since his opponents are not going to be all that heavy raiding, or rather raiding heavy, as TSMs, it's probably not going to matter all that much. So first relic is better building crush armor, not half bad, of course. And otherwise, let's switch to the next guy in line for... Oh, of course, I'm going to switch to the left side for TSMs into Atlantis, who is right now playing yet again pocket, as the Oranos he is right now. So scouting with the goat at the back as well, trying to discover the monkeys in here. Also with the Oracle, the berries and whatnot, what's happening behind this back TC. Whereas in the forefront, he has discovered a relic, which is higher villager hit points. Oh my. Isn't this sweet between two Oranoses? Yeah, it is. So let's see if somebody picks it from the opposing team. I wouldn't necessarily expect so. So this could be potentially a pretty big advantage for TSMs. For the raiding in the early game, there's an extra relic in here, which is Gold Trickle. Better than nothing, it's not bad. Anything that's free is good. At least in Age of Mythology, not really in real life. But otherwise, TSM player is the last one to have a look at, and you can see that everybody is happy killing Rhinoceros for the Chinese market. So that's that, and it seems like that the hunt otherwise is going to be a bit in the forefront with the gazelles, and yeah, I almost saw here something on the minimap. That was nothing. There are gazelles in the forefront for Atlantis, whereas at the back, just the monkeys that we have seen a bit earlier. Some giraffes, that's what we wanted to see, especially for Atlantis. And we are going to see extra hunt in here, just monkeys. But since we are looking at Oranos, it's not going to matter all that much. Some extra rhinoceros in the forefront, with of course some gazelles also for him. He's already in the forefront, but since he is facing Titu, that's also going to be a very interesting encounter between Titu and Fen, because Titu is basically main Oranos and one of the best Oranoses in the game, especially in team games. So I'm fully expecting him to make time very difficult for Fen, and let's see if Fen can handle what is in front of him. Well, it'll be seen in the minutes to come. Themista is in the pocket yet again as a Loki. Not sure if that's the better choice or not, but well, he could be booming or whatnot, but probably would be happier about the Zeus being in the pocket, the chef, but it's not going to be matter all that much, probably, because both players are pretty skilled. This is cheaper siege weapon costs, not awesome, potentially for the Zeus and Helopola in the Mythical Age, and you can see that chef is actually curiously going for the hunt at the back. He probably hasn't discovered anything in the forefront, just rhinos that are very far away and unsafe, so that's not something you want to go for. The same as those berries, which would be quite slow indeed, and otherwise he doesn't see anything. Just some giraffes, which are basically Themistas, so he was kind of forced to go into the back, and he doesn't have all that much in here, just extra giraffes with berries and a relic. With three monkeys, which usually is not really great, but at the same time it could be helpful. The early raiding, and you can already see that Atlantis is moving in as he is the first to advance and pretty fast. 357, and right now Oracles are coming in with nicely placed spy. And yep, Themista is right now forced off the hunt. And is it going to disrupt this advance time? No, it isn't. But it's probably going to screw him up in the early game, because obviously Temistai is Loki, and Loki's want to build as many harassers before, or rather during advance as they can. This is going to be a bit problematic for his strategy right now. He also likes to go for extra upgrade. He already has pickaxe actually. So yeah, not really all that much of a problem. But this is very nicely played by Atlantis, and Temistai is going to be quite nicely slowed. Not by much, but every second counts, and you can see that even those two, with the three just loafing around, are doing a pretty decent damage, and those three might actually be even killing this build temple. They actually will be killing it. Well, that's a huge problem for Temistai, an underestimation from him. Well, quite nicely played by Atlantis, and a very nice counter to Temistai's strategy. And this is going to put them in a pretty big advantage, TSM, so nicely played, really. I have to repeat that yet again, because this is a pretty big problem for Temistai, and definitely something that he wasn't counting with. He's right now even housed, because he wasn't expecting that he will be building a temple the whole duration of the advance into the next age, and not even finish it. So, pretty big problem for him, pretty big problem. At the same time, there's already a bit of a raid in by player on him. And you can see interesting spy by Temistai placed actually on the Raiden army. That's not half a bad idea, because they were expecting exactly due to the god choices that they will be under attack reasonably soon. And they wanted to see where the attack is coming from, as opposed to where they should be raiding. So that's very nice thinking at the same time by Temistai, even though this was, yeah. You know all what? Well, this was very nice from him at the same time. So nice thinking, and with the wall finished by Chef, this raiding is going to be at least slowed. It's going to be killed the tower, or rather the wall, reasonably soon. But yep, you will know. You will know what to do. Tito also being raided by his opponent Fen. So far it seems like that Fen is having slightly upper hand, especially in the numbers. And even though those three heroes are coming in, they are going to be joined. The army from Fen is going to be joined by reinforcements as well. But it's not going to be enough, because the blue army is slightly closer, the military buildings are slightly closer. But they also need to be careful, and Titu needs to be careful with those willies, so that he isn't caught off guard and doesn't take some bad battle. Just waiting for some shockwaves, which are still not being cast. But of course, since they don't work on heroes, why would you actually cast it here? That's a pretty big army, so he really needs to be careful. But he doesn't want to relinquish those Jiras, because he doesn't have enough hunt at the back. He has literally nothing. He will be forced to go into the middle, and that might not be the worst course of action, because it seems like there's not any kind of raiding by TSM Zeppelin so far. So it could be reasonably safe for the game to come. So there's a lot of raiding coming in from Atlantis and also his teammate player on Chef. Whereas Temistai is so far doing not much, as he's also been raided slightly by player. And this is really quite nicely played so far by TSMs. And since they are getting a very nice map for exactly the god choices that they have, they should be having the upper hand in the minutes to come. But let's see if it's going to be enough, because so far there are quite enough goats for Chef. With pickaxe being in, decent, not half bad. And towers, I would be expecting, will be researched reasonably soon, because they definitely need to be. If he doesn't research them, he will be just open to raiding onto the gold in here. This one is basically stopping any kind of gold raiding. And, well, he is facing quite a lot of opponents, so yep, he needs help. That's first, from Temistai. Second, he needs towers. And third, he needs to hope that he can actually survive this raiding. Otherwise, at the bottom, Titu seems to be successful in actually forcing Fen's villages from the hunt, as opposed to what was hoping, or was what Fen was hoping to do to him. So that's a pretty good job. But Fen seems to be thinking that he needs to change the venues and go into somewhere else, and basically allow his villages to do whatever they want, whatever they do best, and that's hunting somewhere safe. At the back, not much interesting stuff. Just Chef was trying to go for a bit of a food, but obviously that's not going to be all that safe for him. And otherwise, he's inside his own base, still not having the towers, unfortunately, probably doesn't have the resources, and he still doesn't have enough help from his teammate Temistai, who is just catching 4 Herseers with 8. Well, that's not really effective, is it? army is definitely needed somewhere else, but it seems like that chef is actually recuperating with the medium hippocons right now, so that's nicely played from him. Having mediums, it should be enough if he plays this correctly. If he finishes this wall, he will be reasonably safe next to the berries in here. Attempting to finish the wall, the top failed, but with all the armies actually arriving at the same spot for Temista and chef, it seems like that the crisis will be resolved for JSS quite nicely. At the same time, there's a pretty big battle at the bottom between T2 and Fan, with T2, well, it was 1-1 on the checklist, but T2 seems to be winning. But he needs to send reinforcements rather soon. The battle is going, yeah, equalishly. Let's say equal. Whereas in the middle, it's also kinda equal. So they are just, yes, and Fan and T2 are just catching each other across the map, whereas the first player, first team to actually go for second DCs are all three TSMs. Well, they are definitely jumping the gun in here, and I'm thinking that they are doing a pretty good job, because GSS are not even thinking about second DCs so far. So yep, that's going to be a pretty nasty surprise for UK for Jesus in this decider. Tencent just about finished for Fan, and this is also pretty important because it's quite nice defensive position to fall back to for Fan if he is under some heavy pressure from T2. And even though all the armies are right now at the same spot, the advantage of the town center is going to be known. It's going to be quite important for the battles to come. So that's that, as T2 is attempting to enter his opponent's base, whereas there's still quite some raiding by player, but with a very, very nicely placed spy. Yeah, JSS know absolutely everything about it, and they don't need to worry about anything at all. This oracle is though very nicely placed. Very nicely placed for the back gold to actually see. And he can go for a bit of raiding. And Chef, well, he is. He's trying to protect T2, but he is kinda at the wrong spot. But with the manor being exactly nearby, it's no problem for T2, so he should be finishing with the second TC soon as well. At the back, not much happening for yellow, as he's right now moving into gold spot. And in here, seems like that he was going for a bit of a raid in Temista, but has been repelled by double army of player and Atlantis, and he definitely doesn't have anything against that, so he needs to move somewhere else. Chef is kinda hiding under the candelabra. This is basically as unsafe place for Hunt as can be, but at the same time, I'm pretty sure that TSMs wouldn't expect this at all. And if these guys will find them, that's a shame. That's a shame. That's really a shame, but at the same time, pretty nice idea by Chef, and pretty gutsy. Well, he's going to pay for it though, because he's going to retreat, and Turmas are going to wait for him in here. Or are they? Yes, they are. But Temista is also on the spot, exactly as the hero that he is, and he is noticing quite well. But all those villagers are probably going to die anyway, so even though it's going to cost some units to TSM, this was well worth it, because Chef has lost five, or rather, two villages. This one is half dead with two hit points, but two villages, but much more importantly, he has lost a hunting spot, and that's a bit of a problem, because he doesn't have all that many of them left. He has just some berries at the back, some lions potentially, and there are some giraffes, so yeah, that could be something to take potentially for Temista or whatnot. They need to be careful not to kill actually this one Herzir that is having the spy, because that's literally quite nice spy and doing wonders for JSS. And we can see the first player advance into heroic age for TSMs, whereas for JSS Temista is already in, and he's all over the map. As you can see, he's having troll on the left with Kataskopos waiting for the underworld passage together with the oracle scout, and he's also in the middle raiding inside green's base, and also defending in the middle. Or yeah, well, I was hoping that he's defending in the middle, but he isn't. But he is still having some kind of army together with Chef in the middle, trying to somehow repel what is happening from players still with this very important Herzir. Kurt Pikroer, yeah, that's the traitor for TSMs. And we can also see that three TCs are the reality for both T2 and Fan, so they are having very equal battle. But looking at the positioning of the battlefield and how T2 is moving forward, it almost seems like that actually T2 is having an upper hand in the fight against his opponent. So let's see. That's going to result in decisive victory, 32% into Teya. with the two not advancing yet. It's kind of shame. Chef is not advancing yet. Well, he's usually quite happy to stay in classical for 20 minutes, so that's not anything all too surprising for him. But he needs to be careful so that he isn't surprised by his opponent, the SM player, because he is in the heroic age already, and potentially might be playing the strategy as he was playing in the previous games. And that's quite fast jump into the next age, as fast as he can. So you can see that Atlantis is actually housed. Attempting a bit of a raiding in here somewhere. Is there enough protection? There's actually too many villages on this gold mine. Well, that's kinda sucky. Taking shifts. In shifts and breaks, and well, there's, oh, pretty decent raiding by Fen. And he is actually going to be pursued by T2, but at the same time, T2 is also having a pretty decent army right next to Fen. How is that possible? Because Fen is having just one army. T2 is having two, and they are having the same amount, actually, of town centers. Well, curious. At any rate, though, it's working for T2 quite nicely. He's probably some kind of magician, but he doesn't have any upgrades. And I would be expecting that maybe, rather, this purple player isn't having anything either. Yeah, he isn't. But this is a pretty bad raiding on Temista, who is losing villages in here. 1, 2, 3, maybe about 4 or whatnot. But he's also, Atlantis, or rather, Fen is also going to lose the army in here because it's half dead and he's going to be facing full health units, especially with the Prometheans. So, yep, good job. Good job by T2 in eliminating Fen in here and also going into a bit of an offensive on the left, but he seems to think a bit better right now. So Atlantis has invoked a shockwave somewhere, I'm not exactly sure where. But much more importantly, the SM player is right now losing his main TC. So that's very nicely played by the Raiden by Temista, and well, this could be a pretty big problem. And basically turning the game around, because player is right now, it's just one TC. Probably going to lose the second as well, as I don't see him doing anything about this. And also, Temista has stolen one of their back TCs. Oh my. Oh my, Temista is going to decide this game. Especially with flame weapons coming in, and with no counterplay to that, they don't have anything. Player cannot even use his own, because he doesn't have any army. And with, yeah, Chef joining in the fun, basically... kicking the dead horse in here. Yeah, player is going to get owned real hard. Real hard indeed. So yeah, that's a pretty nice play. Town center, goodbye. At the bottom, still just a bit of a race in here with T2 right now, trying to prevent the palace as much as he can. Well, he's right now going to be repelled next to the TC, but it's not going to matter all that much, as in the middle, Temista is still having another part of his army, and with a few units from Chef, he is able to control Atlantis quite nicely indeed, even though Atlantis is at 3 TCs right about now. So player is basically deleted out of the game, which is pretty sad for him, of course, even though TSM Fen is right now in Mythical Age. Casting Tartarian Gate on Temista. And this is going to work quite nicely. He's going to kill the town center. Quite assuredly. Because I don't think there's enough army from Temista. And well, I don't really see enough for Chef as well. Chef is right now moving fully into the offensive. Is he going to the next age at least? No, he isn't. Yeah, as I said earlier, he's quite happy to play in the classical age. It's working for him very nicely. Quite nice hunt, or rather, gold gathering from Temista at the back. Very safe indeed. But he needs to... Oh, he needs Oxcart. It's finally moving in, but hell yeah, and I guess it's going to take quite some time, so they are having a bit of a walk-in, those dwarfies in there. And let's look how T2 is doing in his battle against Fen, who's Fen already been in the Mythic Raid, so Fen is doing a pretty good job against T2 with copper shields in here. Whereas T2 is having copper weapons, so yet again, difference in approach, but it's of course going to mean that T2 is losing a TC down to 2, which should allow Fen to maybe even beat T2 head on. But I'm not exactly sure it's going to matter all that much, because you can already see that Chef is moving into the middle. Pretty nice attempt basically to stop the nonsense raiding, that Atlantis nonsense raiding from the point of GSS, because it's actually doing pretty nice damage into their economy, and TSM Atlantis is going to be forced to defend himself fully, and Chef is going into full-on raiding. At the same time, Temista is right now facing flaming weapons for player, because player has amassed enough army, and it seems to be in a pretty good spot, actually. Because he's fighting right next to his military buildings and he's popping out Hersiers exactly as he needs, and they are going to be turning in the battle around. Especially with the healing coming right now for TSMs, so pretty good job. And Themista is right now forced somewhere else. He has also lost the TC in his home base due to the Tartarian Gate, of course, as we have expected. So that's one nicely placed Tartarian Gate, but he's still having one right behind his opponent's bases. And he has one for taken at the top. Some idle, pretty important actually, mythical units could be destroying buildings in here. And well, he is attempting to kill what? He needs to kill the DC and keep it down, because you can see that player is actually hoping that he can go into the next age, and he's maybe more than that, using the market actually to somehow get resources for his military. But it seems like that he's basically out of the game. We don't see all that many villages from him. Just a few at the back as a bit of a dwarf fight. Is there? Actually, yeah. That's a bit of a dwarf fight, but Stimfalian Bird seems to be thinking otherwise. He's just going to be killing all the guys from Themista. So, yep. Themista needs to retreat from this spot. But let's go back to the home base of Claire, where he is right now fighting with the help of Atlantis, but also under attack from Chef. In the middle, it seems like that Tito is getting his... is as handed to him so far, with Fen playing quite nicely indeed. So he is definitely doing a pretty good job. Whereas at the bottom there was a bit of a raid in by Chef with the Hippicons, but it doesn't seem like that he's going to continue with that for much longer, because Atlantis is catching up with him and slowly but surely killing all those horses. All those horses. Just now clicking into Apollon. Still no extra upgrade from either of those players. Fortifying TC from Atlantis, but not Mythical Age. And pretty important raid in right now on Atlantis by Themista. So Themista is right now thinking that he doesn't really need to worry himself with the opposing army. He just needs to kill their economy, which is of course a pretty good thought. And let's see if it's going to work for them. So far it's working quite nicely. This crap army is not going to do it, but at the same time, in the base of player, he is on the cusp of regaining his TC, and Themista needs to be careful, because he isn't even interested in taking the TC in his home base, because obviously he still didn't take care of the Tartarian Gate, and well, that's potentially up for the taking for the opponents. Even though there's a bit of a front scouting by Chef, it's still wide open, and they could be doing something exactly like Themista, and taking TCs from their opponents at the very back. Yes, Tito right now building a trade, but also being raided by Atlantis. But with Chef right now advancing into Apollo and Heroic Age, he should be a pretty strong force to be reckoned with, especially if he jumps into Mythical Age. But even if he just goes for heavy Hippicons, as they will be a pretty strong army, to get rid of anything that stands in their way. So those Murmillos are of course going to help. Heavy Murmillos with bronze shields and copper weapons, whereas the Zeus is having at least copper shields and mediums, but well, that's probably not going to do it. So TSM player has finished with the TC, so he's going to be slowly creeping back into the game, as he's actually at 2. Haha, that's a bit of a surprise, and oh well, Chef is going to be surprised in here, as Themista has lost the TC at the back and he's at 0. He is at 0, and he is definitely underestimating the situation quite strongly. He basically just thought that this is a one game when he deleted player, but he didn't delete him altogether, and they weren't able to finish, because Fen is doing a pretty great job at the bottom against Tito, and Tito is slowly but surely losing. You can see he's still holding ground, but it's nothing more than that. And without Mythical Age and without upgrades, that's not going to work out. He is having just Archai. Not even mediums, whatnot, having just copper weapons, whereas his opponent is having heavy bronze shields and copper weapons, and this is just a disaster waiting to happen for Tito, because he doesn't have extra TCs. He could potentially take ones from his allies, but he also needs to actually advance into the next age. So far he isn't. Themista is also being heavily raided, and I'm kind of not sure what the plan right now is for JSS. Because the Chef is not going to finish the TC without the ceasefire. And I don't think that ceasefire... Oh, they actually don't have ceasefire. I completely missed this. Chef went for restoration. For some obscure reason, to be honest. I have absolutely no idea why restoration. But that's pretty bad problem for them. Because Even though he might be attempting to go into the mythical age, which he right now advances into, I'm not exactly sure if he will be fast enough to do some nonsense in here. Themista is still just trying to take things from the back, without any TC. But he needs to be careful, he needs to capture at least this one, which is still not guarded by by TSMs for some reason. But this is all going to be up to Jesse's T2 if he can hold against Fen. Fen is right now though at 4 TC, so the chances of T2 holding are basically close to zero, as he's facing the same god with extra upgrades and whatnot, with Atlantis right now being in Mythic as well. And since Themista is like non-existent, just trying to kill the TCs in here, that's not going to be enough at all. He's right now going to lose absolutely everything, because he doesn't even have the military buildings. Yeah, I'm not exactly sure what Themista plan right now is. Titan Gate is, or rather Tartarian Gate is still in here. That's of course a pretty big problem. But it's going to be up to Chef to somehow secure the game for GSS right about now. He's having the TC in the middle, so he's at 3. So that was front TC of Themista. And he's building in the middle, literally. So he will be trying to control what is happening overall. And potentially, he will be trying to eat through the middle with Helepolai into Atlantis. And at the same time, help his ally Chef, on, or rather, Life T2 at the bottom. And hope that he can somehow advance into the next age. 45 TC is pretty important, and potentially even somehow turn this back. The SM player though is back to Raiden. He's back to Raiden, and well, so far not fighting anything, but he will quite soon find those gold wheelies. I'm pretty sure of it. So yeah, that's a pretty big problem. With Themista yet again changing sides, having the baseline of upgrades, since he is heroic age and whatnot. But there's yet another vortex, and it's going to be at the back and with the spy on the villager. Oh well. Yeah, yeah, that's a big problem, because there's absolutely no counterplay for JSS by for this. So that's that. At the same time, also pretty heavy raiding on gold release by T2, and I'm very afraid that this might be a GG right there. Because JSS, actually Themista, I'm not exactly sure what he did in this game. I don't know why he didn't actually build extra TCs and whatnot, but he is right now more or less non-existent, and Chef is going to be in a pretty tough spot, because he needs to retreat back, and he doesn't have enough to help his teammate. And you can see that T2, even though he's really fighting quite valiantly, being unupgraded against heavy upgraded ally, rather opponent, he's doing a pretty great job, 2 TCs against 4. It's probably not going to be enough, because Raiden is quite heavy from TSM player, and yeah, you can see that even Titan is coming up. So yet again, TC is down for Chef, and he doesn't have any kind of army in here. He's just pushing through in here, and maybe Themista somehow can salvage this, but he doesn't have anything. He just gathering resources at the very back, military buildings just inside his base, one long house, one temple. That's literally it. That's literally it. And well, this is just a complete ravage of Chef's base. So yep, this is... I don't see how actually JSS can come back from this, and I'm very close to call actually the SMs for the win, but let's not be hasty. We have seen last game, and the situation was looking pretty dire, that they were able to turn it off, turn it around JSS. But I'm not exactly convinced it's going to happen in here, and yet GSS are resigning, and TSMs are the RTS League champions of Season 26. Very nicely played by TSMs, very nicely played, and weirdly played by JSS, but still, pretty nice push on player who was dropped to 0 TCs, but he was able to come back very, very nicely, whereas Themista wasn't able to do the same, and that was exactly what decided the game. So nicely played, TSMs. Nicely played, TSMs, and congratulations for the win. Especially a player, really, the comeback from the 0 TCs was the crucial part of the game, because that allowed him to help Atlantis enough to put Themista out of position, and Themista wasn't able to recuperate from that at all. And at the bottom, a very nice play by Fen, who basically 1v1'd T2 and beat him straight, fair and square. In the end though, T2 was doing a pretty great job in the defense, that has to be said. So Fen, as the MVP, I have to agree, he played really, really well, and basically owned the bottom part of the map, and he was having strong echo. Well, so much better than T2. But they just steamrolled the extra TCs and whatnot. But at any rate, that's a pretty big difference. The civilian units and whatnot as well. So nicely played by Fenn. And the early attack by Atlantis, that was also pretty important to put Themista out of his game. And it really worked quite nicely as well. Alright then, GG. GG, and congratulations, TSMs! Tsunami Clan is becoming the champions of RTS League Season 26. So, good job, and enjoy your title and returning back to the throne. They have been a champion some seasons ago, and they are coming back. But it has to be said that GSS have made the finals quite great as well, with their very nice play in all of those games, coming back from 0-2 into 2-2 and losing in the decider, and they played really, really well indeed, and definitely deserve the banner for the silver as well in this season. So good job both teams. I definitely hope you enjoy those great games, all five of them. All five of them, and yep, this was a match to remember. This was definitely a match to remember for the times to come.